I need all the Acroflyers to meet on the stage. All the Acroflyers, make your way to the stage, please. All GCA Acroflyers meet on the stage. All right, how's everybody doing tonight? Doing all right? Yeah, some energy over there. I like that. I like that. We're looking forward to tonight. It is a fun night for my team. They have been working all year long for this show. The other shows are great. We love going out to the different schools. We love traveling. But the build-up for home show, this is where we're performing for parents, for our friends, for everybody here at home that we love. And that's what makes this special. I will say, it started already a little bit. I love an interactive crowd. We will at times pull up some volunteers to come out here and do some moves with us. We will we'll hopefully hear a lot of cheering and clapping. If you see something that you like, let them know that. Let them know that. I've always said the more they know that, the higher they toss, the better the sequences go. If you see someone panting and out of breath, it will be me. But we're looking forward to tonight. My kids, like I said, they've worked hard for this. Before we start, though, I just want to start with a word of prayer. If you guys can bow your heads, and then we'll get started with the show. Father God, it's a great night. It has been a beautiful day. The sunshine outside. We had an outdoor Sabbath today, out in the nature that you created. We can't forget that. We can't forget that we are your creation. You're the one that made us, that knew us before we were even born. It's awesome to think about that. The care that you have for us, it's astounding. And as we come out tonight, as my team comes out, and as we put on this show, we ask that you could give us the strength that we need, give us the focus and the balance that we need. Let us have fun tonight and just enjoy this show here, a chance to kind of showcase the talents that you've given. Draw close to us in everything that we do. We love you very much. In Jesus' name, amen. All right. Without further ado, I will introduce my team.
Our freshman guys, we have Campbell, Bruce, Dylan, and Zane.
Freshman girls, Emily and
Aaron. Our freshman, Kylie, and sophomore, Annie.
Phoebe and Callie, sophomores. Jason and Ben.
Senior.
from the junior class, Joey and Jason. Aspen, Carla, Aaron, and Garrett.
Where is the tiger? Where is the tiger? Where is the tiger? Here is the tiger.
From the senior class, Adam. Also from the senior class, Jamil and Sam. Things up with the team, our captains, Carla, Sam, and Karen. And your rocking extra hip coaching staff.
Shannon, Clint, Travis, and Bruce. There you have it.
All right, parents, if you would like to take a quick team picture, they're going to do a pose there for you.
To us. Coach Fox, could you come forward, please? We love Coach Fox. This home show, our theme is decades and decades of gymnastics. So what we're going to be doing throughout the show is interviewing people from the past, and as we go, you'll see we'll get more current. But Coach Fox has been around a long time. How many decades have you been here, Coach Fox?
Oh, too many. Way, way, way back. Got here in 75, 76, my first year here. So, been a long time, long time. Next year will be 40 here.
All right. In all your years coaching, what was the hardest move you saw achieve?
Probably a couple. You had a name for it. I don't know. I don't remember the name, but we call them Big Scott and Little Scott. Very talented double for guys. And we were at a clinic, and it was an Olympic move where they went through the back slid down through the back. You grabbed him and threw him back into a low hand-to-hand. A very difficult move. And these guys accomplished it. They got back home, worked on it, and that was a great accomplishment. One of the most difficult things, because not many got it at that time. And also the other thing, we went to Southern College for our AcroFest, and we had the whole team in a butterfly, and we rotated 360. And that was kind of fun. It was kind of a difficult move for everybody to do that together. But that's the two I can remember.
When you were the coach, what was your most, the equipment purchase that you got that you were most proud of, like a new piece of equipment here?
Probably our floor. We started with 4x8 mats. That was it. And we put them along for mat passes, and we had our safety mats for vaulting. When we did it, we started out with pure gymnastics. We did the bars, the rings, the unevens, the beam. Those were things that were started back then. That was kind of what was popular, and it evolved into what's going on now. But probably the floor. When we actually got rid of those 4x8s and got our 40x40 floor, that was really an accomplishment.
And what is your greatest memory of your team? Do you have a special memory?
You know, I can't think of a special memory. I really can't, because every year was memorable. No matter what team I had, there was something special about each one of those teams. So rather than, I can't really be specific on that, except the experience was fantastic. I enjoyed every year, the accomplishment that the students made, what they did. And so I can just say the memories were great from all of them. That's what I like to say.
If you guys get an opportunity after the show, there's some really cool pictures of Coach Fox with a really epic mustache. Be sure to check that out.
Yes, if you noticed in the lobby, that's a little bit of, there's some pictures from the past. We had some models out there earlier that were modeling some of our transitions in uniforms, because through the years we've had many different types of uniforms. I know our guys wish that the guys' leotards would come back, but I don't know if they ever will. So thank you so much, Coach Fox, for all you do and for letting us interview tonight. Our next routine we are proud to introduce. It's our very newest routine, and we have not performed it before. You guys are the first ones to see it. It is our swing routine. Enjoy.
Oh, yeah.
Where do we interview? Hey, where do we interview?
Hello. Hello. All right. Can Miss West come out on the mats if possible? Hello there.
All right, so what years were you on the Akron Flyers team?
79, 80, and 81.
Ooh, nice.
Of all the shows that you perform, like, which one stands out most in your brain?
Here in the gym right here, at the end of the Gear Home show.
Sorry. What was your favorite move while you were on the team, and why?
My favorite move was probably my doubles partner's routine.
That's good. Well, thank you for letting us take some of your time out in the show. It was nice of you. Okay.
And our next routine will be wall walking, so give him a round of applause.
Fever is rising,
and those drums begin to burn.
Swain, King of Swain, King of Swain, King of Swain, yeah.
Yeah. Can Mr. Scott Martin please come out onto the mats?
What years were you on Acro Flyers?
I was on the gymnastics team from 83 to 86. Maybe 82, I can't remember back that long, but it was either 3 or 4 years.
So how many times a week did you guys practice?
Just like y'all do, every day. Yep.
For an hour long, or like 2 hours, or 3 or 4?
I don't remember. I think it was kind of like what y'all do, right after class or right around supper time and then right up till rec. So, of course, on Fridays, because of Sabbath, we would cut it down some. But
So, when you were on the team, did they still have tryouts, or was it like anyone who came got it?
No, we had tryouts. Our team was a little smaller, but we did have tryouts.
Okay, the next routine is mixed bag. So,
All right. As you can tell, we have a whole variety of routines that we work on. But then there's also just a bunch of individual skills, and sometimes we like to just show those off. So this is a routine, we just call it our mixed bag. It's a little bit of everything. When we go to the schools, I just kind of call out some of their individual skills and let them show off the things they've been learning. So guys, come on out for mixed bag.
Rock, 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 rock
stage, you'll see us do a lot of elevators. Let's do basic elevator here. All right, basic elevator here. Half up, full down. Here we go. Half up, full down. Hey, Brandon, come over here. Still over here. Here we go, ready. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2. All right, excellent. All right, let's do retake, pull. Retake, pull down. Ready, up. Five, six, seven, eight. 1, 2. All right, flat back. Here we go, ready, up. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2. All right, now we have a few individuals that have been working on some sequences. If you'd like to show off your individual sequence, go for it. Next group. All right, let's hear it for Kelly. Series. last tumble, you can definitely do a caterpillar. Let's go, caterpillars. This is one you can try at home.
1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 3 o'clock.
A different press. She's going to start the press for you tonight. Here we go. Ready up? All right, standing back handspring. Standing back handspring. Just did passes, let's do our hand to hand.
Hand to hand.
Or a high armed arm. If you have your high armed arm, you can do that too. Hand to hand, high armed arm. Here we go. Ready, up. All right, log rolls, log rolls. All the log rolls, we're missing a lot. Here we go, ready, go. Give me that cock circle. Rock, 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 All right. For this next part, we are again going to need some audience participation, some help. Okay? So, we started this last one with some dive rolls. We're going to try and see if we can get a few brave volunteers that we could dive over. If you're willing to risk your life. I mean, if you're willing to be brave out here. All right, here we go. Set it up, guys. Hey, Karen, Carla. All right. Let's get a couple volunteers. While they're getting a couple volunteers, guys, let's warm up some dive rolls. Here we go. Go ahead and give them something. All right, here we go. First one through. Oh, hold on, wait. All right. All right, here we go. We're going to start with a few of these. Okay.
Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. It's not warm when she's away. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone. And she's always gone too long.
All right, here we go. Here
anytime
we go.
She goes away. Wonder this time where she's gone. Wonder if she's gone to stay. Ain't no sunshine when she's gone.
That's entirely too easy. Let's get a few more.
No home.
Let's get a few more. Here we go. Who else? Me. All right, squeeze in there close. Squeeze in close. All right, this is over seven. Going over seven. Here we go, guys. Here we go, we need a couple more. Alright, squeezing close right next to each other. Okay. All right, here we go. All right, this is over nine. This is over nine. Here we go. Only go if you can make it. Only go if you can make it. right, let me get my elevator groups out here. GCA, am I elevator groups? Elevator groups, let's go. All right. This is your chance. If you would like to do an elevator, my guys are going to come out and work with you. The big frame top. Keep your legs locked out. They'll lift you up. When they push, you sit like you're sitting in a chair. Here we go. This is a great opportunity for you to come out and take some pictures if you would like to. If you have a friend that's up there, feel free to come out. This is also a great time to get some refreshments at the concession stand. We have pizza and drink and desserts if you would like something. Cheer your friends on here.
Poca picchita va bene, se tu la parla mi è americano, quando si fa l'amore sotto la luna, come te viene in cave di I love you, papà l'americano. Parla miez americano, quando si fa l'amore sotto la luna, come te viene in cave di I love you. Papà l'americano.
Last couple elevators through. Mm-hmm. All right. One of our recent acquisitions for our team is our tumble track. It's actually made quite a difference for our tumbling. It's really been improving. We want to take just a little bit of time to show you some of the work we've been doing on tumble track. This is also audience participation. I'm being very, very careful here. If you are an alumni, you are on my team, so I know how well you tumble, and you would like to tumble, I'll let you come out and tumble a little bit. If you were not alumni and you're an amazing tumbler, I would love to see it sometime, but it won't be today. I appreciate you guys, okay? So, GCA, let's warm up a couple tumbles here, and then if I've got some of my alumni that would like to come, you can as well.
If it hadn't been for Cotton Eye Joe, I'd been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe? If it hadn't been for Cotton Eye Joe, I'd been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe?
From Cotton Eye Joe.
All right, do your final things, final tricks.
Married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe?
Lots of craziness here. Real quick, hey guys, go ahead and set up for Cirque. We should do that before Jason and Joey do something crazy. Oh, nice. Okay. Go ahead and bring your chairs in, set up here. All right, earlier I mentioned that we are selling concessions. Every year, as we do our home show, we work towards a fundraiser for equipment purchases. Last year at Home Show, we were working on a new landing mat. If you saw our 12-inch landing mat last year, it was in very bad shape. I want to thank everybody. If you were here last year and you donated, it is awesome. If you see our 12-inch landing mat over here that we use for our 4-high, it is great to have a new, safer landing mat. It's really wonderful. As we go into next year and we're setting up for Cirque, if you'll notice, this chair has a little Band-Aid on it, kind of. Our chairs have been here for years, and they've done a good job. Who was it? Wally, did you make these chairs? What's that? You had them made? Okay, I believe it was Clint. Was it your grandfather? Hey, Clint, was it your grandfather that made these? Okay. Anybody know how long ago that was? Do you know how long ago it was? It was more than 6 years ago, because I've been here for 7 years. And they've been here for years before that. Anyway, Shannon said, some of them were made many years ago by the Amish. You'll notice that there is a difference between the two. These, which are shakier, and these that were solid. And we have, like, we call them our five good chairs and our five bad chairs. And unfortunately, this is one of the good ones that just broke. So it's getting us through, but this is something that we're going to be fundraising for next year. So please eat heartily. It just helps our program. And if you are interested, if you would like pizza, do that. If you would not like pizza, but you would like to donate, we would accept that as well. We appreciate it. Thank you.
City breaking and everybody shaking, and we're staying alive. can you show your head? Oh, you wanna know? Oh, you wanna know?
Okay, guys. Travis and Clint, come please, come out. What years were you both on the team?
I was on the team in 97,
98.
96, 97, 98. Oh, sorry. Okay, what was the biggest trip that you guys went on?
Acrofest at Andrews University was the biggest one we went to.
Same here, Andrews University, Acrofest.
Thank you.
Oh, okay, it's on.
Okay, so he says that the bass is the most important, but that's not true because without a top, there's no bass. Wait, no. Without a
The middle is the most important. Glue holds everything together. The bass just stands there.
Okay, thank you very much. Our next routine is guys' routine.
Thank you.
can Dean Doug Nesmith please come on to the mats? Hey, Dean. So, you're never on the team, but you did coach it. What years were you the coach of the Acroflex?
I think it was from 97 to 2001, or somewhere around there.
So, I mean, you did coach the GCA gymnastics team for a couple years, but you've been doing gymnastics much longer, as we can see how you still remember your round off back tuck, surprisingly. And so how long have you been doing gymnastics, and where did you do that?
I started when I was in sixth grade, and I was doing gymnastics all the way through high school and college.
What was your hardest tumbling pass that you've ever had?
My hardest pass was one that I called the round off full flop. I do a round off and a back flip with a full twist and land on my stomach.
That's interesting.
Well, you also did some juggling too. What was the hardest juggling thing that you've ever done?
Juggling and gymnastics go a lot together, and so I did a lot of different juggling things. I don't know what the hardest one was, but we had four friends that would get together, and we'd all juggle at the same time, throwing the pins at each other, and that was a lot of fun. So that was the hardest.
All right, thank you for your time. And the next routine is doubles.
Thank you. All right, I need these two lovely ladies to please come down to the mats. Raimi and Asher, everyone please welcome them with a round of applause. Raimi and Asher. So, for everyone, can you please tell us what years were you guys on the team?
I was on my junior, senior year, so 12, 13.
Yeah, about the same, around there. I was on and off. I was on and off the team, sometimes sophomore year, then like junior year. I didn't try out senior year.
So why did you guys join gymnastics in the first place?
Clint was like, you're on the team. I was like, I don't want to do gymnastics. He was like, no, you're on the team. I was like, okay.
I was for selfish reasons. I just wanted to go on the cool trips. So that was my reasoning.
So what advice would you guys give to people considering trying gymnastics?
Love it. Just do whatever you can. If you love gymnastics, if you love trying gymnastics, just do it. And don't be afraid.
Yeah, just like don't worry about getting hurt because a lot of people are. Like it's just an injury. You'll be fine, most likely. So like just don't worry about it. And when you're trying new things, just don't think about it because that's how you get hurt. Just like do it.
All right, thank you so much. The next routine will be the... Actually, we don't have a routine next. Coach Bogus has some things to talk about.
All right. Been a great night so far, but there's a lot of work that goes into it, and I have a few people that I need to stop and thank. I have some awards to give out. The first person that I want to get will... My seniors do so much on a team. Seniors are really the heart and soul of your team. They set the tone for everything that we do. So I'm gonna thank them. Before we do, though, I want to thank all of the parents that support their kids in this program. They give of their time, they give of their money, they support us in so many ways. I know that there are parents that have helped with the concessions tonight. Again, a huge thank you to that. I have some volunteers over here. Most of them work for me, but I appreciate them. But like I said, this is a special night for our seniors. Let me get, hey, all my seniors, come out over here where I can call you up quickly. Every year we do a senior recognition award for the leadership that these seniors provide. So I'm going to call your name and come up and get your award, please. We're going to start with Ben Rhodes. Ben Rhodes.
That's Sam Cardona. He's a captain. He doesn't get hurt.
All right, next we'd like to get Oren Chandler. I know that Oren's first love is football, but he makes for an awesome gymnast. Thank you, Oren. Okay. Next, I'd like someone that I have been able to bond with a lot tonight, Rashid Logan, my throwing partner. All right. Let's hear it for Garrett Stevens. I will say a word about Garrett. He was unofficially voted the funniest person on our team. We love him. All right. Oh, I don't know. This one's meaningful to me. And I don't know. I think I'm careful how I say this here because I want to make sure that this comes across right. But I have somebody that's on the team this year that tried out twice and didn't make it twice and tried out again. And, whoo, look at me choking up, right? What was that? Get back in there, Tier. Hey, seriously, Adam, come on up here. I can tell you this. Adam fully deserves this award. All right, next one, incredibly talented. I appreciate him because pretty much any time I needed a special music, it was Josh playing for me. Josh Robinson, come on up. All right, next award, another senior who's been one of the hearts of our team. Amazing passion and dedication for gymnastics. I'm so glad, I told him today, I'm so glad that he came here. He had started at a different school. Sam Cardona, you're amazing. Come on up. All right. I don't know. A little bit of a funny story for this one, too. If you walked into my house today, this person works for my wife and bonds with our family a lot. And on the chalkboard in our house, it says Karen Bogus was here. So Karen, Maura, come on up. All right, I have the last three to give out are a very special award. It says, in recognition of 4 years of dedication to the Akron Flyers program. 4 years is hard to do. High school is busy. There's a lot of people that come their freshman year and they want to just wait and feel things out first. There's a lot of other things to pull on their time. I don't get a whole lot of four-year seniors. The ones that I do have shown without a doubt that they love and care for gymnastics. So these next ones have been with us 4 years. I'm going to miss them. So let's start with Jameel. Jameel Henderson. All right, and our last one here, this is fitting. She tends to be the last one out of the gym a lot of times. We're talking gymnastics. She has an amazing passion and dedication for gymnastics. She's been doing it, I believe, her whole life, pretty much. So, Carla Ponte. All right, my last few, I don't know, I already have them up here on the mats. And I say this every year, they have amazing dedication. You saw the interview with Clint and Travis earlier, Shannon as well. They have been here way longer than me. They volunteer of their time and their energy. I could not run this program without them. So special thanks to Clint and Shannon and Travis. And my last one, she hates this, but she has such a great costume tonight. I couldn't just give her the flowers quietly like I normally do. My wife... I will say, she puts up with a lot. She puts up with a lot.
So, apart from thanking our coaches, we, as the captains and the team, would like to thank our coaches for an amazing year. It's been a lot of fun, and we couldn't do it without them. They make our team feel like a family, and it's been a great pleasure. So we want to say thank you, Coach Bogus, Clint, Shannon, and Travis. You guys are amazing, and we love you.
Okay, we have another interview, but before we have that interview, I want to tell you, I want to do a couple things. Coach Bogus thanked us because we volunteer, but the truth is, even though he teaches here, and I've been wanting to say this for several years, because he does work here, but the time he puts in is above and beyond what he gets paid for. So truly, he is a volunteer as well, because he puts in, and so does his wife, puts up with a lot too. Sacrificing time as a family, and we just appreciate them so much because they just do an amazing job here. The other thing I wanted to say is I have a little commercial that I didn't practice. So if you've ever been looking for someone to be a secretary for you, but you just didn't know where to find one, I know the other day I was sitting and I needed someone to type out something for me, and I was like, Callie Coker, can you come over here? So Callie, this, in case you don't know who Callie is, this is Callie, she's a sophomore, and she is an amazing secretary, which happens to be running for SA secretary this year. So, if you want to vote for Callie, she's highly endorsed by Dr. Gerard, Dory Bogus, and many, many others. So she comes highly recommended. So please vote for Callie.
All right, our last interview of the night. I need the 4-year seniors to come out here, please. Give them a round of applause.
Aw, come on.
You can clap louder than that. So how many years were you guys on the team?
Three. Four years.
All right. Past 4 years they've been on the team. Now, what was your favorite memory from gymnastics?
Handstand competitions, definitely.
Probably, I hope Bogus doesn't get in trouble for this, but I'm leaving, so it doesn't matter. We went up to Nashville, and it was a lot of fun, and we stayed up until 2:30 in the morning playing dodgeball with our entire team, and it was just an awesome memory.
Well, now that you guys are leaving us here this year, what are you guys gonna miss most about gymnastics?
Okay, I'm going to miss definitely the family aspect, because as going on, like, I've seen so many different people come through, and it's awesome just being able to, like, meet new people and share the same passion that I have.
Yeah, the friends you make, and the coaches are really patient, things like that. So, yeah.
All right, thank you guys so much. Can you guys please give them one more round of applause? Our last routine of the night will be our AcroFest routine. So please welcome the rest of the AcroFlyers out onto the mats. Thank you.
In the beginning, God created the world, a world in perfect harmony with God's law. But Satan entered the garden, and Adam and Eve challenged God's plan by eating from the forbidden tree. And thus entered the seeds of sin and rebellion. Man's focus changed from fellowship with God to the fulfillment of his own selfish desires. And those selfish desires influenced all decisions. Humanity was altered. Our sinful nature turned friends against friends and turned brother against brother. Over time, the world changed. The seeds of sin grew and spread until today. Our world bears little resemblance to God's perfect creation. Violence, theft, and domestic abuse fill the media headlines, and they devastate victims' lives. Satan's goal is to pervert that which God created perfect. Hatred has replaced love, and that hatred has led to distinctions. Distinctions that were not drawn by God, where man and women are now not judged by their character, but by the color of their skin. Even death, the wages of sin come for everyone, too often in terrible circumstances. Accidents, hunger, war, and disease, these claim lives every day. Innocent people face death, even when it is least expected. And then disasters, like 9/11, have brought a new face to death. Terrorism. Safety cannot be taken for granted. Instead, Satan works his destruction. Even in a simple marathon through the streets of Boston. Life's new form now bears little resemblance to God's original plan. Yet as Christians, we're called to live another way, to not be conformed to this world, but instead to be transformed through God's redeeming love. Jesus said, Blessed are the pure in spirit. Blessed are the peacemakers. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst after righteousness. And then God sent his Son to redeem the world. Jesus suffered the consequences of sin just as we do, and worse, suffering even to the point of death. But through his sacrifice, man is redeemed. Jesus says, I go to prepare a place for you, that where I am, you may be also. Once again, man and God will live in perfect fellowship. All right, it's our tradition here at GCA that for our final prayer, we would like to invite anyone that has been on our team in the past to come join us here on the mats. If you've been a member of a GCA team at any point, I know we had a bunch of our alumni that we interviewed today, come on out and join us, please. At the end of every practice, we always circle up like this. Our circle's a little bigger now, and I love that. It's great to see where we've been from before. Everybody bow your heads, please. Father God, we can't begin to thank you enough. You know the challenges that we've been through this year. You know the joys and the triumphs that we've had this year. And I love how we end our show, knowing and looking forward to a time when we will be able to put all of those results of sin, all the heartache and all the trouble and all the stress away, and be able to just live in harmony with you in heaven. That is such a wonderful promise that you give us, and we thank you for that every day. Help that to be the focus, whether we're doing gymnastics or singing or working on the finals that are coming up, whatever it is that's going on in our lives. Help us to reflect and represent you in that. We love you. Amen. Thank you for coming tonight. We appreciate it.
Ready?